Good morning and a very warm welcome. You are watching Janata Television and this is English Bulletin with me, Yutsa Bhattarai. The top stories first. Prime Minister's nephrological treatment begins in Singapore. Doctors say only 30% of Prime Minister's kidney is functioning. Commuters face everyday hassles along Kathmandu-Hetauda route. Unhealthy competition among drivers a risk for passenger safety. Government to strictly implement Labour Act. Labour Minister urges all enterprises to get listed in Social Security scheme. 200,000 Rohingya rally to mark Genocide Day in Bangladesh camps. Nearly 1 million refugees living in Bangladeshi camps. And England beat Australia by 1 wicket to win third test. Sensational stocks helps England level the 5-match series. And now the news in detail. Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's nephrological treatment has begun at the National University Hospital of Singapore yesterday. Prime Minister Oli will undergo plasmapheresis treatment to remove antibodies from his kidney. Only 30% of Prime Minister Oli's kidney that was transplanted 12 years ago is functioning. The doctors involved in his treatment said, "This is the second time in 2 weeks that the Prime Minister has reached Singapore for treatment. His treatment primarily involves reducing the number of antibodies. The number of antibodies increases in patients who have undergone kidney transplantation."
Kidney ma sudhar aayo ki aayena? Sayad aile aayeko information anusar ke dekhincha bhane apeksha gare jetiko sudhar dekhiyena. भनेपछि एउटा स्टेपको ट्रिटमेन्ट त चालिसकेको थियो, दोस्रो स्टेपको ट्रिटमेन्ट चाल्नु पर्यो. अर्थात् त्यो शरीरले उत्पादन गरेको एन्टिबडिज शरीरबाट बाहिर निकाल्ने क्रम चाहिँ गर्नुपर्ने बाध्य हो र त्यो सुरुवात गरियो भन्ने कुरा अहिले आएको छ.
Doctors involved in the treatment of Prime Minister Oli have said that his kidney might function above 60% after the treatment. However, if the treatment is not successful, he will have to undergo kidney transplantation once again. Prime Minister Oli's personal doctors have ruled out the possibilities of complication in case of kidney transplant, arguing that he is in good health. Doctors are hopeful that Prime Minister Oli will return home soon after a successful treatment. Nepali Congress has expressed concerns regarding the ongoing internal clash within the ruling Nepal Communist Party. National Assembly members Ramesh Jung Raimaji expressed dissatisfaction at the upper house meeting yesterday over the tussle between two top leaders of the NCP. Raimaji added that the feud has discouraged cadres of all political parties for working together to institutionalize democracy and federalism. MP Raimaji said internal clashes in any of the party affects this attainment of national prosperity as it prevents parties from coming together to work on mutual issues.
हामी नेपाल कम्युनिस्ट पार्टीले झन्डै झन्डै दुई तिहाईको सरकार निर्माण गरेको छ, बनाएको छ, र त्यो दम्भले गर्दाखेरि अहिले पनि राजनीतिमा अहिले विचलनको बाटो फेरि आउने अवस्था सिर्जना भइरहेको छ.
National Assembly member Balram Baskota of the ruling Nepal Communist Party, meanwhile, lashed out at the government for not taking any action against former Crown Prince Parash Shah, who mistreated police personnel at the airport last week. Other members of the upper house talked about contemporary national agendas at the special hour. Anyone found delivering irregular and substandard work in the urban development program will be penalized, said Minister for Urban Development Mohammad Istiaq Rai. Minister Rai's statement came yesterday after members of the Development and Technology Committee of Lower House raised questions regarding the series of misdeeds in urban development programs. Minister Rai also directed the secretariat's present at the meeting of the lower house to carry out an immediate inspection of the programs and punish the wrongdoers.
अनिवार्य रूपमा अहिले नै समिति बनाएर कर्मचारी पठाउने अनुगमन र नियमन गर्ने कमजोरी भेटिया छ भने हामी कारवाही गर्छौं त्यस्ता ठेकेदारलाई.
Minister Rai further clarified that the construction of landfill sites in different cities across the nation had to be stalled because of unavailability of sufficient land and obstruction caused by the locals.
Landfill site nirmana bhayo ra sanchalan ma hami gairahechhau jaha samasya natra chahi football ma ei ekle bhancha jagga dinchu arko le banauna dinnau yaha bata bohar huncha bhairala ko kei cha dhangadi ko kei cha sabai ko
The House Committee has also directed the government to identify the causes for the failure in implementation of government policies to establish new cities and to find effective solutions to it.
नयाँ सहर निर्माण गर्दै जाने सरकारले नीति अनुसारका अनुसारको कार्य प्रगति अपेक्षाकृत हुन नसकिरहेको अवस्थामा सो कार्य हुन नसक्नको कारण पहिचान गरी प्राथमिकताका आधारमा प्रभावकारिताका साथ उक्त कार्यलाई अगाडि बढाउन समिति नेपाल सरकार सहरी विकास मन्त्रालयले निर्देशन गर्छ.
The committee also held discussions about the prospects of new cities and waste collection and management with Minister Rai and authorities from the concerned departments. This is Janata Bulletin. We will be right back after a short break. Welcome back after the break. We continue with other national news. Unhealthy competitions among the Tata Sumo drivers of the Kathmandu-Hetauda route has caused panic among the commuters. On one hand, the travellers are continuously harassed at the ticket counters by the transportation management committees, while on the other, they have to worry about the way that the drivers drive on the narrow road. A report.
The route from Kathmandu to Hetauda via Ferping is by far the quickest route to the Tarai Belt. This route joins the East-West Highway in a couple of hours. This is the reason why this route is mostly crowded. The ticket sellers are sometimes seen forcing the passengers to enter the vehicle of their choice. This is a common scene every morning at Palku. Even the transport entrepreneurs don't like this behavior at the ticket counters. But this unruly behavior of forcing people into the vehicles, taking no care of passengers' luggages, and mistreating women is an everyday routine. The troubled passengers sometimes have to call for intervention from the police. Any physical force applied to the people to get into these vehicles is punishable by law, according to the police.
सार्वजनिक स्थानमा चाहिँ कुनै महिला बालबालिका लाई हैरानी दिने, उलाई जिस्क्याउने, तान्ने यो कार्य चाहिँ गर्नु हुँदैन. यो कार्य गरे भने यो चाहिँ
But the action of police has not gone well with the umbrella organization of transport entrepreneurs who claim they should be allowed to do what they have always been doing.
जानकारी यो छ के रे यो फल्ट गरिराख्नु भएको छ यो नगर्नु होला भनेर वार्निङ दिएपछि त त्यो मान्छे नि त्यसले नि त बुत्ला.
Although efforts have been made to solve these problems faced by the commuters, no concrete solution has been found so far.
The Department of Survey started using satellite image for all development projects. Development projects require high-definition satellite images. These satellite images will be provided by Chinese government. Government officials said that the Chinese government has promised to provide these maps free of cost for another five years. The agreement was reached during a state-level meeting between the two nations earlier this year. The Nepali projects had been buying high-definition satellite images on their own from various map providers in the global market. Janak Raj Joshi, spokesperson of the Land Management, Cooperatives and Poverty Alleviation Ministry, said that there is no possibility of Nepal launching its own satellite at the moment. Chairman of the ruling Nepal Communist Party, Pushpa Kamal Dahal, has called for the party's secretariat meeting for today afternoon. Dahal has called for the meeting at a time when another chairman of the ruling party, Prime Minister K.P. Oli, is in Singapore for treatment. Dahal was given the authority to summon the party secretariat meeting before Prime Minister Oli left for Singapore last Friday. Former Prime Minister Dahal has called for the meeting at the party headquarters in Dhumbarai at 1 p.m. today. The meeting is scheduled to discuss the issues of parties in charge and deputy in charge for the metropolitan city and other committees of the party. And now the news from the economic front. The government is preparing to strictly implement the Labour Act and Social Security Act in all institutions. In this initiative, the government has urged all the employers and employees to get listed in its Social Security scheme by mid-October. A report.
Speaking at an interaction organised jointly by the Ministry of Labour and Social Security and the Hotel Association of Nepal, Labour Minister Gokarna Bista announced that the government will strictly implement the Labour and Social Security Acts. The minister further said that the move is not intended to dictate the private sector, but to create a conducive environment for work. During the occasion, he also urged all the employers and employees to get listed in the government's Social Security scheme by mid-October.
सबै रोजगारदाताहरूले आफूलाई सूचीकृत गर्नुपर्ने श्रमिकहरूलाई सूचीकृत गर्नुपर्ने सूचना जारी भएको छ यो समयभित्र अनिवार्य रूपमा हामीले आफ्ना प्रतिष्ठानहरूलाई आफ्ना संस्थाहरूलाई सूचीकरणमा ल्याउनु पर्यो
मिनिस्टर Bista also said that the government will not discriminate against foreign nationals
नेपाल सरकारले विदेशी नागरिकहरूलाई पनि सामाजिक सुरक्षाको दायरामा ल्याउन चाहिरहेको छ नेपालमा काम गर्ने श्रमिकहरू चाहे त्यो स्वदेशी होस् चाहे त्यो विदेशी होस् मानवीय हिसाबले नेपाल सरकार विभेद गर्दैन
During the occasion, representatives of the Hotel Association of Nepal drew the attention of the government regarding the difficulties in implementing the Social Security scheme. Although there are more than 50,000 enterprises in the country at the present, only 4,000 have voluntarily listed themselves in the government's Social Security scheme.
Time for a short break here at Janata Bulletin. Stay tuned for latest international news. We are at the end of Janata Bulletin and the headlines once again. Prime Minister's nephrological treatment begins in Singapore. Doctors say only 30% of Oli's kidney is functioning. Commuters face everyday hassles along Kathmandu-Hetauda route. Unhealthy competition among drivers a risk for passenger safety. Government to strictly implement Labour Act. Labour Minister urges all enterprises to get listed in Social Security scheme. 200,000 Rohingya rally to mark Genocide Day in Bangladesh camp. Nearly 1 million refugees live in camps in Bangladesh. And England beat Australia by 1 wicket to win third test. Sensational Stokes helps England level the 5-match series. And that's all from the English News Desk for today. You can follow Janata Television and our programs on various social media platforms, including on our website, janatasamachar.com. Keep watching Janata Television. Namaste.